When dividing complex numbers, or writing complex numbers in fraction form, we're not allowed to have I in the denominator. Remember, I is equal to the square root of negative 1, so this rule is very similar to not having a square root in the denominator of a radical expression. So when the denominator is just an imaginary number, we can eliminate the I from the denominator by using the fact that I squared is equal to negative 1. Notice if we multiply this by I over I, the denominator would be 3i squared, and then we could substitute negative 1 for I squared. This would simplify to negative 3. But we do prefer the denominator to be positive, so instead of multiplying by I over I, we're actually going to multiply by negative I over negative I. And now we'll go ahead and multiply. In the numerator, we'll have negative 6i, and then we'll have plus 7i squared. And notice the denominator is going to be negative 3i squared. And now we're going to substitute negative 1 for I squared, both in the denominator and the numerator. So we're going to have negative 6i plus 7 times negative 1 all over negative 3 times negative 1. And now let's simplify this again. And we're going to go ahead and put the real part first and the imaginary part second in the numerator. So notice how we'd have negative 7 minus 6i. And we can leave the quotient in this form, but sometimes this is also broken up into two terms where we have the real number first and the imaginary number second. So if we did that, notice how we'd have negative 7/3 minus 6/3 I, but 6/3 simplifies to 2, so we have negative 7/3 minus 2i. It can also be expressed in this form. Now let's look at our second example. When we have a complex number in the denominator that has both a real part and an imaginary part, we're going to multiply both the numerator and denominator by the complex conjugate of the denominator. So because the denominator is negative 3 plus 4i, we're going to multiply by negative 3 minus 4i over negative 3 minus 4i. So we'll have four products in the numerator and four products in the denominator. So we'll have negative 2 times negative 3, that's 6. Negative 2 times negative 4i, that's plus 8i. Positive 5i times negative 3i, that's minus 15i. And then positive 5i times negative 4i, that's minus 20i squared. And then in the denominator, we'll have negative 3 times negative 3, that's 9. And then negative 3 times negative 4i, that's plus 12i. Then we have positive 4i times negative 3i, that's minus 12i. And the last product is going to be 4i times negative 4i, or minus 16i squared. So now we're going to combine the imaginary numbers and substitute negative 1 for I squared. So in the numerator, we're going to have 6, and then we have 8 minus 15i, that's negative 7i, or minus 7i, minus 20 times negative 1 for I squared. Notice in the denominator, we have opposite and imaginary numbers here and here, that's 0. So we have 9 minus 16, and then again, I squared is equal to negative 1. So looking at the numerator, we're going to have 6, this will be plus 20, so 26 minus 7i. The denominator is going to be 9, and this will be plus 16, or 25. So we can express this quotient in this form, or again, if we want to, we can break this up into two terms. The real part would be 26/25, and the imaginary part would be minus 7/25i. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.